What's up everyone? Today I'm going to be talking about Monster Hunter Legends of the Guild, which is out now on Netflix. Now anyone who knows me knows just how much I love the Monster Hunter series ever since Try It on the Wii. So hearing they were making an animated movie gave me high hopes for seeing this series come alive. Now yes, of course we did have the live action movie with Mila Djokovic, but let's face it, that movie was a slap in the face to the fans of the games and just to film lovers in general. It was pretty trash. Anyway, can Legends of the Guild redeem my faith in games being made into movies? Well, let's find out.
Elder Dragon is on its migration path, straight for your village.
Directed by Steve Yamamoto, Monster Hunter Legends of the Guild is a fairly short movie coming in at just under an hour in length, and it follows a young hunter named Aiden who is voiced by Dante Basco, who some might remember played Rufio in Hook and voiced Prince Zuko in Avatar, as he takes on his biggest challenge and fights to save his village from destruction by an elder dragon. It's a simple story and with only an hour to set things up, introduce characters and monsters, things do need to move pretty swiftly. However, that goes against some of the character development, and when a team of hunters finally get together to beat not just any old monster but a powerful elder dragon, you do start to question if things were a bit too rushed. In fact, I feel like had this been made into a series, they could have fleshed out the characters a lot more, really got into the past of some of the hunters we meet, and just helped to develop the story a bit more in depth. As it was, things feel flat, and even moments that were meant to have an impact just didn't land as well as they were expected to. The voice acting is fine for the most part, but the dialogue is weak at the best of times, which is a shame because although the games aren't filled with much better dialogue, you would expect a bit more from a movie where the characters are the focal point. The animation isn't much better and can come across as a bit bland with stiff and clunky character movements. This is especially apparent in the faces of the characters, which can come across very basic and awkward looking. Saying that, the armors and most importantly the monsters are very well detailed and look great, which is a big positive, but unfortunately we don't get to see many proper monster battles in this film. Again though, with the short runtime, it's understandable and the build up is for the big battle at the end. I wish I could say it was worth the wait, but it all went out with a bit of a whimper and not a blast. Now look, this might all sound like I hate this movie, and hear me out because I really don't. It may be because I'm a fan of the series why I expected a bit more, but at the end of the day, Monster Hunter Legends of the Guild is a fine movie. If you were to remove the Monster Hunter brand from the movie though, you'd find something that was average at best. If you're a fan of the series and have an hour to spare, you may just like Monster Hunter Legends of the Guild, as there are a few things in this movie to appreciate. I just wish it had been made into a series to flesh things out a bit more, and the CG animation on the human characters could have been worked on a bit more too. I was disappointed in the end, but it's a step up from the live action movie at least, which left a bad taste in my mouth. I mean, who even greenlit that movie? I feel like someone at Capcom could have said, "No, you're not doing that to our franchise." Anyway, have you seen Monster Hunter Legends of the Guild? Let me know what you thought about it in the comments below, and thank you for watching this review. Hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll catch you next time.
Buddy, if we run into trouble, plan A is run away. Plan C, D, and E are hide, negotiate, and run away.